Math Humans. We're going to do 5.2b today. We're going to be integrating trig functions that also include natural logs. Our objectives are exactly the same thing. So just as a review, if I integrate a function to the power, remember that I increase in power for an integral and then I divide by the new power. And then, of course, if it is an integral with no limits, then I'm going to have a plus c. Sorry, I'm having a brain fart. So I've written down the rules, and these are on your formula sheet. So these are just the new things that we are going to cover. So this is just more information for us to manage. As we work through these equations, we're also going to be using U substitution and our graphers. So let's just jump in with our first example. So the first one says I want to solve the differential equation, and we're going to have dy over dx is equal to 1 over x natural log x. So remember that when I solve a differential equation, the first step is to do separation of variables. So it's to get all the y things together and all the x things together. So I'm going to cross multiply. So I'm going to get dy is equal to 1 over x natural log x dx. If I'm solving, that means I'm trying to find y. So now I'm going to integrate both sides, and I'm going to get y is equal to. So on the right-hand side, I'm going to let u equal the natural log of x. My du is 1 over x dx. And if you'll notice, we now have everything that we need. So my integral becomes 1 over u du. And this is the natural log absolute value of u plus c. I substitute my u back in, and so I'm going to get the natural log absolute value. My u was the natural log of x plus c. So yes, that looks pretty weird, but it's actually just a relatively nice equation. Okay, let's move on to our next example. So example number 2, and we're going to solve another differential equation. And this one is going to be dy over dx is equal to x minus 2 over x. So again, the first step is always to do my separation of variables. So I get dy is equal to x minus 2 over x dx. Now I'm going to integrate both sides. On the left-hand side, I get y. On the right-hand side, I'm going to split this up. And I'm going to write this as the integral of 1 minus 2 over x, and then in parentheses, dx. Okay? So I did x divided by x to get the 1, and then 2 divided by x is here. So this one, I could technically rewrite it as 1 dx minus, and I would pull the 2 out front, 1 over x dx. Okay? So in case you didn't know, if I tried to use the properties, the power property, so if I have my 1 over x, I could write that as x to the negative 1. And if I tried to integrate it, a negative 1 would be raised to a power, so it would be a negative 1 plus 1, which is 0. And then I would divide by 0, and then the world would explode, which is why we have that the integral of 1 over x dx is the natural log absolute value of x. So I can't tell you how somebody developed that. I just know that the reason we can't do our power rule is because I can't divide by 0. So then if I integrate, the integral of 1 dx is x. The integral over here, this is just a negative 2 natural log absolute value of x, and then plus c, and then I'm going to put my y, and then we are done. Alrighty. So if I wanted to find a particular solution, so this is the general solution. Now let's try to find the particular solution. And if I'm going to find a particular solution, they have to give me a point. And in this one, they're giving me a negative 1, 0. So finding the particular solution means that I'm going to try to solve for c. So I'm going to substitute my x and y into the equation. So I'm going to get 0 is equal to a negative 1 minus 2 natural log absolute value negative 1, right? This The absolute value of a negative 1 is going to be, I'm going to mark it off there, the natural log of 1, okay, because the absolute value makes it positive, and here's this negative 1. This goes to 0, because remember, the graph of the natural log crosses at 1, so the value is 0, and so then I can solve for C, so I'm going to get C is equal to 1. So my particular solution is going to be y is equal to x minus 2 natural log absolute value of x plus c. Alrighty, that's it for that example. Now let's do our next example. So example number 3. And this one says evaluate, and we're going to do it by hand just because we need to have that practice. And I'm going to have the integral from 0 to pi over 4 of the square root of 1 plus tangent squared x dx. Well, in this one, it's helpful to remember our Pythagorean identities. So my integral from 0 to pi over 4 of 1 plus tangent squared x is secant squared x. And then the square root of secant is just secant. So I'm going to have the integral from 0 to pi over 4 of the secant of x dx, and this is going to be the natural log absolute value. This is one of our new rules, secant x plus the tangent of x evaluated from 0 to pi over 4. Okay? So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to use my special right triangles, and then I'm going to evaluate. So I have the natural log secant of pi over 4 plus the tangent of pi over 4, and then minus the natural log of the secant of 0 plus the tangent of 0, okay? All right, so as we start filling this in, this is going to be the natural log absolute value, the secant of pi over 4. So remember, pi over 4 is here, and it's 1, 1, radical 2. Secant is the reciprocal of cosine, so if the cosine is 1 over radical 2, that means the secant is going to be radical 2. The tangent of pi over 4 is 1, and then minus the natural log, the secant of 0, right here, there's my point 1, 0, is the reciprocal of cosine, so that's just going to be 1, and then the tangent of 0 is 0, okay? And then the natural log of 1, remember again, that comes from the graph, really helpful to remember, it crosses at 1, this is 0, so my answer is going to be the natural log, and I'm going to write it as 1 plus radical 2, and so then I would report my answer. Well, the integral from 0 to pi over 4 of f of x dx is equal to the natural log 1 plus radical 2. So not too difficult, just a new handy set of rules. All right, we have one more example for today, okay? So example number 4, we want to find the average value for f of x is equal to the tangent of x over the interval from 0 to pi over 4. Okay, so I'm going to graph y is equal to the tangent of x from 0 to pi over 4. And so the graph would be kind of like this. Here is my pi over 4 and 0. Okay, and this would be the area. So remember, the formula for average value is going to be 1 over b minus a times the integral from a to b of f of x dx. So now I'm just going to do this math. So my average value is going to equal 1 over pi over 4 minus 0 times the integral from 0 to pi over 4. And so if you think about average value, just to go back and kind of review, an average is the sum divided by how many. This is going to be the sum divided by how many, okay? And then I'm going to write my tangent of x dx. And just to remind us about the importance of notation, when you write an integral, you always have to include the dx, and the variables always have to match. So if I do this math, this is easy. I'm going to multiply by the reciprocal, so it's going to be 4 over pi. And then I'm going to get times the negative natural log, absolute value, cosine of x. And then I'm going to evaluate from 0 to pi over 4. So my average value is going to become 4 over pi. And then I'm going to do the negative natural log absolute value cosine of pi over 4 minus plus the natural log absolute value cosine of 0. And then we're going to finish that. The cosine of 0 is 1, okay? And then the natural log of 1 is 0. The cosine of pi over 4, so here's my 4 over pi. And then I'm going to move the negative right there. Natural log, the cosine of pi over 4 is 1 over radical 2. And I'm going to put that in its absolute value bars. And you could stop here, except that you would need to say that your average value, except I spelled it wrong, is equal to that. You could also give me the decimal equivalent and do 0.441. Okay, that's it for today. I will see you soon.